This year, the October Salon will be in one venue here at Rysavska Street. This is the former military headquarters. This part of the building was not bombed in 1999. And this once was the military academy. And we are really happy to have the exhibition in these premises because of the memory of things that has happened, all the history which is embedded in this building. This relates very much to the concept of the exhibition, which wants to focus on perception, memory, how we represent reality. We want to focus on both individual memory and collective memory, which of course brings us into the issue of history. So both the construction of history and also the reconstruction of history. This exhibition gathers 20 artists represented by more than 25 artworks. And these are artists from all over the world, I would say. It's a truly international, you could almost say global exhibition, with artists from both India and South Africa, North America, of course, Western Europe, Eastern Europe, the Western Balkans. I'm curating this exhibition together with my colleague, Celia Prado, who is unfortunately not here today. And we believe, for us as curators, the aspect of accessibility is important for us. So we hope to curate an exhibition which will be relevant both to the initiated art audience, to be relevant in these local contexts, but maybe also have the capacity to be interesting and important also to a larger audience. We also hope by choosing to work mainly with artists using moving images as their medium, that this is also a very effective medium to encounter both initiated art audience and maybe also people that has not yet before encountered contemporary art. Probably this building in itself will draw attention and we will probably have people coming here, not least to look at the building, because this is the first time this building is opening up for the general audience. And we work with artists that have the capacity to catch people's attention, I think, from the first moment of encounter. But these artworks also, of course, have underlying layers of significance that you can work yourself through depending on your own interests and the time that you wish to devote to the exhibition. But surely it's an exhibition that you can visit and revisit several times. Also, what is moving images? Because before in contemporary art you used to talk about video art, but actually within the business you don't really talk about video art anymore. So now we're talking about moving images, and in this case, in this exhibition, it's not so often this kind of one screen on the wall. It's more like you walk into a room and you encounter a complete situation, a larger installation. So you walk into the work and you become a part of it. And this is also something which is a great difference between what you could call video art before and now. And today we also have a very strong poetical aspect in the artworks. We have seen a long period of documentary productions, I would say, but now we have a much more poetical, subtle way of expressions, sometimes almost surreal. Several of these works want to tell different stories. So many of the artists have a strong interest in society, in what is important for people in general, and also in this region. And therefore, I hope that we will give Belgrade an exhibition that can be important in this local context.
thank you.